how do we get to that ability to make waves? First, you've got to experience the waves personally, just by jumping in, just by going to that, whatever may be terrifying or overwhelmed with feeling, and getting in it and feeling it around you.
I want to be in it. Like, I want to be in the pond. I'm not just going to like stand on the shore and paint the pond. I'm going to like put myself in the pond. I think it's about kind of like the intensity of feeling and having the conditions of strength of experience and strength of feeling be communicated in the painting.
Last time I was out here, it was spring, and trying to pay attention to what's in bloom right now. I think that Scotch broom was in bloom in the spring, and now we have lots of goldenrod and these mystery wildflowers. I don't know what they are, but when I get home, I'm going to look them up.
You can't just put things on your vision board. You have to move towards them. You have to have action. You have to make things happen. I think that's a really important lesson to learn in life. Like, oh, it's great to, you know, make a vision board, but you can't just do that and just like lay on the couch and expect things to happen. You have to, you know, you have to physically, mentally move towards something.
Walk the streets looking for people. I'll look for light. I'll look for situations. I'll look for expressions on people's faces. I'll look for dogs, families, things that I might find interesting, or the way people dress might be interesting. I might follow somebody for a little bit because I like the way they look.
There is this thing that I'm still chasing after within portraiture. It's sometimes a moment of reflection, right? When somebody's just, you know, their mind's wandering or someplace else. Other times it's, you know, a moment of intensity. With painting, right, I could try to recreate a moment in a sense, or slow down through the act of painting. It also transfers a certain energy.
Other artists feed my creativity. I mean, I look at other people's work and I'm inspired by other people's works, photographers, artists, writers. I look at that work and I see something in all of this that gives me inspiration for my work.
When I've painted plein air, I kind of want to be on the street and, you know, the people walking by, hey, put me in the picture. What are you doing? You know, like there's a sense of, fun about so the nature of Provincetown, if I reframe that a bit as like, you know, the nature of the street and the, you know, the pier.
I mean, the light always affects you wherever you go, I think, and there's this particular kind of magical, inexplicable light in Provincetown, and it changes with the seasons, and it's not quite golden. It's just like this really special kind of light. It has like a effervescence, and like the air is kind of zesty, like champagne bubbles or something.
Art has always been therapeutic for me. And so the combination of walking and being out in nature, and there's nowhere like the National Seashore. I mean, we're so lucky to have all of this open space, and I really need my alone time. I need quiet time. And to be able to go out on a walk and see hardly anyone, just be able to find a spot, sit down, and just soak up the beauty of this environment, like that's when I feel like when I make my best work.
Sometimes it feels like nothing.
When you discover a pattern of gestures in your head and you kind of lose your mind, you kind of escape your mind, it's not exactly an out-of-body experience, but you know, you lose track of time. So that's, you know, there's that initial mark pouring blue ink across a white page. And then there's like your mind following that ink and losing track of the room you're in, the chair you're sitting on, the steps you're taking, and just following the lines of that ink and discovering pattern, discovering illusion.
It feels completely free, and I feel completely without any stress. I never worry about making a mistake, because I don't believe in mistakes. I never worry about, oh, imperfections. I just am the most free, and that is a joy and a magic that somehow I can completely relax.
You know, there's actually a kind of a delight and a weightlessness in not caring, because you're distracted enough by what's happening in the creative process. And it's lighter. It you know, feels maybe sometimes really hard and really uncomfortable. And then we, you know, hopefully can sustain long enough that it's joyful and wonderful and deeply pleasurable.
If anything is a feeling, it would be like this sense of contentment, right? A sense of like being right where you should be. But if everything's working, you know, time sort of disappears and you get into just this act of making. It's not even necessarily considering the full image, but for me, I get lost in this, the magic of like making marks that all of a sudden come together and, you know, create form, you know, or create likeness.